One of the very interesting tools that Canva provides is the ability to create a website. Yes, you can create a website on Canva and you can create it for your brand and you can share it and people can click on things and it's your website and you can create it for free. I'm going to show you how you can do that today, but I'm also going to share with you why I like it and why I don't. So if you're interested in Canva websites and learning more about it, let's get started. For the best advice and tips on growing your audience with fresh content ideas, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you'll get my latest uploads every week. To get started creating a website using your free Canva account, you can go to templates, go to the business section, and click on websites. This is going to pull up multiple different website templates. And one of the nice things that I really love about Canva's searchability is you can filter your search results for particular templates by color if you want to do that. And start with something that feels even more on brand right from the get-go. So I'm going to pick one to start with and we'll get started. But before I do that, I do want to mention that there's actually a couple of different website types inside of Canva. You have these horizontal or sort of made for desktop or laptop type of websites, and they also have mobile first websites. So if you come up to the search bar and click into the search, you can see you have this mobile first website, and that is probably where I would suggest starting because most people are going to be viewing your website on their phone more often than not, especially if you're going to be sending people from social media to your website. So I would pick something from mobile first and then get started. So I've picked this green and peach simple wellness startup mobile first website, and there are 16 different slides as part of this website. Now, I don't need all of these. What I'm going to do is create a website that sends people to my YouTube channel and my lead magnet landing page. So I will only need maybe 3 or 4 of these. And so I think that this first slide I'm going to keep. And then I'm going to look for something that feels good for YouTube, which I think this is a good one. So I will drag that to second. And then I need something that feels good for my landing page. So this one could be customized for the call to action for the landing page. And then I believe we can end the whole thing with a contact section. So I'm going to keep these 4 and delete the rest. So to delete the rest, I'm going to click on this bottom thing here, and I'm going to highlight all of them by holding down the shift button on my keyboard and highlighting all the ones that I want to delete. And then I will delete 12 pages and I'll be left with the 4. So now I'm ready to customize everything for my website. So I've uploaded some stock photos from the Ivory Mix membership. So if you go to ivorymix.com, you can find these stock photos as well. So I've dragged and dropped the image that I want to be at the top of my website here. And when I go to the next page, this will be for the YouTube channel. So I'll want to grab a mobile screenshot of the YouTube channel for this page. If you're interested in adding your YouTube videos or channel to this Canva website template, you can actually go to More and add the YouTube extension to Canva. So you can embed videos right on to the Canva website. So what I've done is I've typed in Ivory Mix and it's pulled up a lot of my Canva and YouTube videos. So I can actually embed these videos onto the template. So I'm going to remove this mobile phone and I'm going to embed the YouTube videos right here onto the template. So now I've added a couple of videos onto the template, and I think what I'm going to do is make this bigger behind just to give a little more visual interest and make some of these things slightly bigger. And I will change the colors in a second to match my actual branding. But what we want to do here is we want to give a call to action. So I've put subscribe to us on YouTube, and instead of having this text, I think I'm going to delete that text and add a call to action button. So I've come over to elements and typed in button, and there are a few different shapes that I could use, but I definitely want one that I can change the color of. So I will use this button. And we will add some text over the top of that. Right here. And right now it's looking very messy. So let's go ahead and start customizing the colors. So if I come over here to styles, I can actually click on my color palette and sort of shuffle around the color palette. That's fun. I think we might want to make that a little less vibrant. And we want to fix the text. So in order to fix the text, you can come over here to Styles and the Brand Kit and click on your brand fonts. Now, if you don't have brand fonts selected, you can just simply click on the text and change it to the font you want, and click on the button and change that to the button color that you want. The one thing that this mobile website is lacking, and that isn't my favorite part of Canva website templates, is that when someone hovers over this button, when they're viewing the website, this button will not change color. So they might not know that it's an active button. So the way that you can make this stand out as an active button is adding a animated element. So if we go to elements and we search through stickers, we want to look for something that brings attention to the button. So you could add an arrow, or you could type in the word click and filter it by animated stickers and use something like this. It just gives the viewer the call to action that this button actually will do something. So now what we want to do is turn this button into a link. So if we highlight over the text, we'll be able to add a link to that text. We're able to click here on this link icon, and we want a link to my YouTube channel. Hit apply. We will test this towards the end. So now that we have the subscribe to the YouTube channel and we have this, we want to change this and the colors as well. So we want to make sure the top of the website really conveys what the website is about and what your brand is about. So for me, this will be customized for my brand and how I help entrepreneurs with their visual marketing and strategies. So I changed this to say smart content strategies for smarter brands. I'm going to change the image, the header image, to more fit the content and the branding. And then I want to add like an arrow below the image to encourage website visitors to scroll below so that they know what to do next when they land on the website. So we want to make sure that we add an arrow. So here I've added an arrow and we'll make that fit more with our colors. So now we have the first image and the second image. Now we need to work on the lead magnet and the contact us page. So I should include, instead of this image, a picture of the lead magnet. And so I believe I have the audience growth roadmap here. And so this will be what they're subscribing. And so I will say this is a freebie, and we want to make sure that these colors fit the brand. So I will click on shuffle the brand colors, make sure everything stays on brand and in my brand fonts. So now that that's been customized, what we want to do is eliminate one of these and add the button and link. We're going to grab this whole thing and we will add the same thing down here below. And so we want to title what this is and add a description. And then we want to update the contact us page. And so I'm just going to make some quick changes. So I've added this different picture and changed the colors around. And so even though I do need to make some updates with words and, contact information, essentially I've got a website ready to go. The only thing I need to do is add a link to my lead magnet landing page from ConvertKit, where people can sign up for my email list. So I will add a link to that here. But for now, I've just added my standard website. And now we're ready to publish this as a website. So in order to publish this as a website, you will click on publish as a website and you are provided with different options. There's presentation mode, scrolling, classic navigation, and standard navigation. Because this is a mobile first website and some of your viewers may view this website on a desktop, the best option is to choose a scrolling website. It will modify the way that it's seen on mobile or on the desktop. So let's take a look at what it looks like on the desktop. So this is the top of the page and you can scroll down and here's the YouTube videos and you can click and play those videos. And someone can click on subscribe and it will take them to my YouTube channel. Here's the freebie with the button to to the landing page for the freebie and a contact us information section. So it's a perfect website, viewable on both mobile and on desktop. So here's what I don't love about Canva websites. In order to share this website with your audience, you must share this link. This link in the browser is your website link. So if someone opens that in an incognito window from their browser on their phone and they click on that link, it will send them to your website. But that link is not very memorable. So the only way to create a unique link like ivorymix.com would to be to purchase your domain and then redirect your domain to this link. Or you can create what's called a bit.ly link. So you can take this link and create a bit.ly link. So to show you how that works, when you create one, you can just put in your bit.ly link and then you can customize what it says at the end. So for this, I created a bit.ly/ivorymix website. So that's more brandable and easier to remember. And when you go there, it redirects the viewer to the Canva website, which makes it really nice. This is a completely free website. Utilizing free templates on Canva and all the elements were free to create this. I've mentioned the things that I don't like are the unique URL and the buttons aren't interactive, so you can't hover over them and they don't interact with your cursor. The other thing is there's very little in terms of navigation. So this is a one-page website. You could create multiple pages, and instead of this button going to my lead magnet landing page, it could go to another Canva web page. So it certainly could do that, but this is just a one-page web page. The other downside to a Canva website is it's not a true website. So you're not going to get search engine optimization and you're not going to get a lot of the features and benefits that you get from having a true dedicated website. However, this is a great way to get started and it's a great way to grow your email list or grow your wait list if you're getting ready to launch something. And you can even sell using these websites. So if you create a PayPal checkout link and a terms and condition and go through some of that stuff and add that to this website, you certainly could redirect these buttons to a checkout if you really needed to. However, I would definitely look at an actual website for that and utilize all the legal and terms and conditions, disclaimers, and things that go along with running a business online. However, this is a great way to get started and a great way to prove your concept for your business if you're just looking to grow an email list or get subscribers to your YouTube channel. It's a great way to get started and it's completely free. So now that you know more, what about the next step? I've put together hundreds of made-for-you stock photos and done-for-you Canva templates with 30 content ideas. So you can get started creating content right away. You can grab it right below this video. It's absolutely free. Also, if you're finding it hard to get new subscribers or connect with your audience, I've got a secret society Facebook group where you can join others and connect with other content creators, and you can get a link to that right below this video as well.